country's strict COVID, zero COVID lockdowns. That video is from Shanghai. You hear protesters chanting "step down," aimed at China's leaders.
.com and these fine retailers.
Welcome back. We have a Fox News alert. Overnight, more unrest in China. Outrage protests erupting now in Shanghai over the country's extreme COVID lockdowns, even demanding President Xi step down. Here to react, Hudson Institute Director for Chinese Strategy, Michael Pillsbury. Michael, welcome. So talk to me about these protests. As we're hearing, they're calling for Xi to step down. They're saying down with communism. Is this a real threat to Xi Jinping or
protests have erupted in cities. Some protesters were bundled into police cars amid calls for President Xi Jinping to resign. Millions of people have been living with COVID restrictions on their daily lives. Our China correspondent Stephen McDonald reports from Beijing.
It's not unusual to see acts of defiance in China, but this was something different. A crowd of protesters in Shanghai chanted, calling for the country's leader Xi Jinping to stand down and for the Communist Party to give up power. A fire which killed 10 residents in Xinjiang last week has prompted widespread anger in China. Zero COVID restrictions have been blamed for hampering people's escape and slowing the access for fire crews. Whether this is true or not, it sparked waves of protest in the regional capital, Urumqi. This has now spread to other cities and university campuses as spontaneous memorial services for those who died in the fire have transformed into demonstrations. People are also blaming Xi Jinping personally for not easing. The zero COVID approach, which is tanking the economy.
Protests have been building in China all year, with people here increasingly sick of zero COVID restrictions. The government seems to have drastically underestimated popular discontent, yet for the moment has no easy way out of the zero COVID corner it's painted itself into. Stephen McDonald, BBC News, Beijing.
Well, Thomas Hale is the Financial Times' correspondent in Shanghai, and he spoke to us from the scene of the protest there.
I'm about 50 metres from what remains of the protest. I wouldn't call it exactly a protest. It was a kind of mass gathering of people. And essentially, they've cordoned off and blockaded the road on which it was happening. But there are still very large crowds gathered, essentially as close to the original site of the protest as they can get. I would say they're extremely significant. And I would also say that the politics of China's COVID policies I'm not sure if you can hear next to me, quite a lot of disruption going on in the street. Sorry about that. But I would say that the COVID policies have become a kind of... which has been a very significant issue for much of the past year. So... I would also add that on the front line of these gatherings, which haven't really turned violent at any point, with a few exceptions, people will talk very frequently about freedom and about democracy and about the need for political change. As soon as you have a kind of critical mass, I think more people are drawn to these gatherings, but when it's very difficult for them to get going in the first place. There are huge, huge risks for anyone who shows up.
And we'll be getting more on that story later. Now, rescue teams in Italy are searching for about a dozen people still missing after a huge